Hello friends, welcome to a new lecture today, and now I would like to discuss about the barrier methods. In the last class we have learned about the natural abstinence method of contraception. Now I would like to discuss about the barrier method of contraception. So in the barrier method of contraception, the first method is using a condom. So condoms are mainly for male contraception, and in condoms here you'll have these condoms will cover, these will cover the erectile penis. These will cover the erectile penis completely, and thus it will prevent conception. Okay, because once they cover the erectile penis completely, the ejaculated fluid does not reach the vagina. And as a result, there is no conception. Okay. So this condom is made up of latex. So we use oil based, we can use water based, not oil based, because it is made up of latex. We can use water-based spermicidal agents along with it. Spermicidal agents. These spermicidal agents contain some chemicals, so these will kill the sperms which are released. Okay, so this easily. So mostly when latex is used, the main side effect of this latex is having irritation. It may cause irritation. So to avoid irritation, now we have new types of condoms which are made up of polyurethane. That is, non-latex polyurethane condoms are available. These non-latex polyurethane condoms, these will prevent prevent the irritation. And they can easily slip and break easily. They slip and even they can break easily. And they are costlier. Okay, now let us learn about the advantages of these condoms and disadvantages of these condoms. Okay, so the main advantages of these condoms include advantages. It is easier, easily available. That is number one. It is cheaper agent, easily available, cheaper, and easy to carry. And it is free from side effects. There are no side effects, or there are very less side effects. Requires no instruction. We don't need a doctor to install the condom. You can directly, the individual himself, he can use it directly with the help of the instructions which are present over the box. As a result, there is no need to, there is no requirement of any instructions. And it also prevents sperm allergy. And if by chance, if the woman undergoes pregnancy, if the woman gets pregnant, then there are no adverse effects on the pregnancy if it fails. Effects on pregnancy. Okay, if it fails, there is no adverse effects on pregnancy. That is one thing which is important to learn. And then, one more thing is, there is a brand which is called as Nirodh. This Nirodh is freely distributed in the government hospitals. In the government hospitals, this Nirodh, it is freely distributed in government hospitals. And one more important, this is one more thing. One more important is, it will prevent sexually transmitted diseases from one partner to other. And the occurrence of the cancer of cervix is also low, decreases the incidence of cervical cancer. So these are the different advantages of this condoms. Now, what are the disadvantages of these condoms? The main disadvantage is, the even in these condoms, the pregnancy rate is around 10 to 14 per 100 women years. Among 100 women, 10 to 14 members can get pregnant, and these the main reason for this pregnancy rate is it can be because of bursting of condom sometimes, or it can be due to slipping of condom. So these are the different reasons. Now, sometimes whenever there is latex based condoms, so for those condoms the women can develop irritation. In women they can develop vaginal irritation. Okay, this should be kept in mind. Then, and this method is coitus dependent. Okay, and some may not enjoy the full sexual, may not obtain the full sexual satisfaction due to the usage of these condoms. Okay, now other uses. I'll write it in the next page. What are the other uses of the condom? What are the main uses of the condom? The uses of the condom is, number one, contraceptive use to prevent pregnancy and conception, contraceptive use. Second, it is used for 12 ejaculations following vasectomy. Even after doing vasectomy, the person may not be completely sterile because there are some reserved sperms which are available. So after vasectomy, at least 12 for 12 ejaculations the person will not be sterile. In such situations we use this condom. And if sperm antibodies are the causes of infertility, okay, then we can use these condoms for 3 months. Condoms are used for 3 months. So during this period, the antibodies will be cleared. So that is one thing. And fourth, it is also used to prevent STDs. STDs like gonorrhea or chlamydia or fungal infection, HIV. All those are prevented by these condoms. So these are the different uses of condoms. So I think you guys have understood something about the condoms. So thank you guys for watching my lecture. In my next class, I'll explain about the spermicidal agents. So thank you for watching my lecture. Thank you.